you were the person who, when I was breaking records, running the national street team, running the promotion department at Bad Boy, you saw something in me. We established a friendship first, and you saw something in me and said, look, I want to bring you on to the management team. And people don't realize that. Actually, this is probably the first time on this show that I've discussed that, but you were the person who said, okay, this guy is great at promotion and marketing. He's doing his thing. He can break records, but he's got something else. Let me bring him on to the management team. And I remember working alongside of you, and then eventually you made me the tour manager, and we spent years and years on the road. But I say this to you, and this is a question I asked James Cruz once before, who came after you and managed Puff. But I asked him, I said, I know my answer when I asked this question to you. But I asked James, I said, what is something that you can tell this audience about Puff that they can't read in a book? So I asked you the same question. You know Puff for many years, long before he became famous, and after he became the person he became, you were right there guiding his career. You were the architect of putting the deal together with Making the Band, which really revolutionized reality TV. You were the one who put together so many of those successful tours that I had the opportunity of being the road manager and tour manager of. But for somebody who didn't live during that era, because right now people can just look at Puff as, you know, he's the guy who owns the Rock. He's a happy-go-lucky guy who changed his name to Love, and he is the father of six kids. What is it about Puff that you can tell us that we can't read in a book?
Well, the first thing is, it's really about a team all the time with Puff. So, you know, there are things that all of us get credit for, but there are people who may not get the credit that participated. And Puff is a kind, really good guy on the inside. But if you can't, like, be loyal enough long enough to see that, then there's no room for you in, you know, his atmosphere. I have a saying that, you know, your talent will make room for you. Everything that you just described about the successes of Making the Band or, you know, Sean John or Unforgivable, all of those things had another very good friend of mine involved named Kenny Masilas, who was the lawyer. And I, you know, knew that he was the lawyer and that he's in charge of that. I'm not the person that knows legalese or, you know, whatever that's supposed to be. We brought a TV manager in for Making the Band and those MTV deals. That I learned from as we built the business and then created Bad Boy Productions or Entertainment. But Puff was like, yo, I got to have a TV manager. And I had to also have the mindset and the heart to know that I needed that because I'm not that. And those things made our relationship work because I hustled enough to be around the atmosphere, but also could stay long enough until he saw like an unbelievable need and me being a part of the team and really how good he is. He wants everybody around him to win. And people don't, you know, tell that part of the story in books and documentaries and those types of things that they have going on. They just tell you the good parts, you know, but they don't tell you the part that, you know, we had other team members that came in and out of his system that were very important. And he really became nicer to me and not even because he never was mean to me, but, you know, he became closer to me because he knew that I could understand when he felt like we needed other people on the team for us to have better success. And by the way, it didn't change my success in any way. I'm getting the same check I'm getting, even if I upgrade Sean, even if Kenny Masilas gets the legal fees, even if the TV guy gets his percentage. It didn't change what my relationship and my worth were going to be in the circle. And Puff has to identify that in you.
Got you.
He has to see that you're necessary, man. If not, you know, come on. Just in the time that we've known each other and over 20 years, he might have had 1,000 assistants.
That's right.
Like, the turnover is great. But if there's a need, like, you know, Farnsworth Bentley, a lot of people remember him from television shows and things like that. But now he's successful in his own right and with his own career with, you know, movie, television or whatever, you know, things.
Working hand in hand with Kanye West.
Hand in hand with Kanye, even right now on Sunday Service. And so you know, just as much as Puff is proud of those people for succeeding, I am too. You are too. And because we identify that in people, we're having this conversation and somebody listening to it that might have knew us 20 years ago and is saying like, yo, I remember that, but they're not a part of it. And, absolutely. And they have to remember that they can change that circumstance though.
What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.